Woo!
Yeah. That's all I can say. How about them Lakers? That's what I'm looking for in a game seven. I mean, wow, that was probably one of the top great games that I've seen right now in my lifetime. Wow, the Lakers just played as hard, really hard down the stretch. Probably the most awesome game down by 13 in the third quarter. Then later they came back and had a 9-0 run late in the game in the six minutes to go. Props to the Boston Celtics. You guys, you made it a game even without Perkins, and you ignored the facts. Doc Rivers did his thing in motivation, and props there. But this was the Lakers' night, and how about them Lakers? This really feels awesome. I mean, now I can finally put this up, number one. Maybe not be number one in total championship trophies, but for this 2010 season, the number one, couldn't have been more proud the way they played down the stretch. Ron Artest put himself in Lakers history with a few clutch shots down the stretch that and one to tie it. Later, hit a big three in the final minute. This was not Kobe Bryant's night, Magnum. You were talking about Magnum with Kobe Bryant being the only guy, but he didn't do much this game. You look at the scoring-wise, sure, he might have had a lot of points on the box score, but you saw what he did in the beginning. He didn't do well. And the others picked up the slack on defense. Specifically, Gasol picked up the rebounds. Lakers shot as bad as you can from the free throw line. I mean, that was such a bad free throw performance early on. It was rough to watch. But Gasol came through with the rebounds. But what Kobe Bryant did do this game, instead of getting the points, even though he did score, he got the rebounds during that 9-0 run. A lot of the shots were not falling for the Celtics. It was just a really huge game overall. Derek Fisher was hurt, but he was able to pull the one shot late in the fourth quarter. He got the one to tie the game and really start that rally. So proud of these guys, the way the Lakers played. And, this ring really belongs to Mitch Kupchak, our general manager. 2 years ago, back in 2008, 2007, Kobe Bryant wanted to be traded. A lot of bad things were going to happen to the Lakers with mediocrity, first-round playoff exits. This team didn't look like it was going anywhere, and Kobe Bryant was on the verge of wanting out. And what he did do, he was able to trade expiring contracts and get Pau Gasol. That's really the thing that has saved the Lakers and how it's been, because without Pau Gasol, we would not have gone as far as we have gone today. I'm very proud of Gasol. We have not lost the Western Conference ever since acquiring Gasol. That's the big fact right there. It was the first Celtics loss in Game 7 of a Finals for Celtic history. But also, huge Game 7 win. I don't even know how this feels, but this is awesome! That's what I'm looking for in a game. As I said, though, with Mitch Kupchak, finally, besides getting Gasol, he was also able to re-sign Shannon Brown, able to, especially last offseason, acquire Ron Artest. I was skeptical of Ron Artest when we acquired him, attitude-wise. He came to play, even though there were times he was on and off and he had streaky moments. He made a clutch shot against the Suns, clutch putback, and in this game, he started slow, but later down the stretch, he was making shots when it mattered, and now Ron Artest has written his name in Laker history. What a performance by the Lakers, and what we've seen this season. Resiliency, they overcame a lot of adversity to start the game. Bad free throw shooting, but they got the stops, they got the rebounds, and they got the 2010 NBA championship. Congrats to all the Laker fans out there, except you fake ones. I can enjoy this, along with T-Spence, along with Deezy. We're running this, man. Lakers all day. And to all you Boston trolls, after Game 5 on my video, there was one guy who had Celtics 2010 chant. If you look at the comment section of Game 5's video, he had to close his account. It's really funny. I just find it funny how much they said the Lakers were choking, they're done because of Game 5. They played hard tonight, and they overcame that 13-point deficit to get the big win. So, congrats to the Lakers. I'll talk about the Lakers draft when it comes, if there's a major transaction in the offseason, but we can enjoy this title. I can enjoy this. First time for me beating a Boston team, you know. All my hatred for Boston all these years. Finally, my team beats a Boston team in the playoffs after all that. After that nasty Tuck rule. Oh, gosh. It's about time. And I'm very proud. So, go Lakers, and enjoy the offseason. For all the NBA fans, looking forward to LeBron James and other free agency. Have a good offseason. We'll see y'all later. Go Lakers. And I'll be talking about the college baseball World Series with the Bruins on my other channel. We'll see y'all later.